When you got your first award?
My first award. And I got my first award.
And social media has become a big boom. How you say that about that?
My elder one is very shy. My younger one... And I'm not a social media person.
What when your daughter...
Or my daughter when she won the... So all those are my trophies.
Compliment you want to give the recent movies.
I loved watching Aavesham. Such a brilliant actor.
Do you have in your life any fan moment?
My fan moment is Arvind Swamy, Mr. Kamal Haasan. Okay. Every time I see Tarak, that's when I'm...
Love this. Your tattoo. What's is all? It's something written.
Names. Avantika and Anandita. My best friend's initials here.
Wow. And a message for all the fans out there.
Be honest to yourself.
Hyderabad, ma'am, we were waiting for you. You do remember when you got your first award?
My first award? I don't know, when was this? I don't even remember when I got my first award.
Huh. And how's your association with IFA Awards? What makes you excited?
I think coming together of all the four South Indian cinema, I think that is what is exciting, because there was a time when people used to say that, okay, South Indian cinema was sidelined. Mm. And I think I have been fighting tooth and nail that South Indian cinema is Indian cinema. Mm. You cannot have a barrier. You cannot have a barricade and, you know, divide it, saying that this is Hindi and this is South. Mm. Because when you talk about Indian cinema, you have the best of technicians, you have the best of actors, you have the best of films being made in South India. And I'm glad that today we have proved it, whether it comes to Oscars or you have to come with the box office records. So even Hindi cinema depends on South Indian directors to give them a box office collection.
And what your daughters say when they see your movies and when you do all such a big role on screen?
My daughters don't even know that I do films. It's like when I make films, and like now very recently we did Baak. So when we did Aranmanai 4, I just danced for the climax song. So the minute I came on screen, people whistled and clapped and there were confettis. So my girls looked at me and they were like, why for you? So that is how they're absolutely oblivious that I have had that kind of a fan following.
And ma'am, you have reached the stage where you can choose the role. So what will be the role and whom you want to work?
See, it's not the length of the role. I think the importance of the role in a film is important. So I wait for something which is very, very interesting. Yes, in the process, you do make mistakes. I did make a couple of mistakes when I was doing films in between very recently. But then I want to do films where I don't get lost in the crowd. You come out of the film and you say, oh, wow, she's done a good, great job. So that kind of an appreciation is what I look forward to.
And social media has become a big boom. Would you spend time, and as your daughters are creating so much of good content on YouTube and, you know, for the social media, how you say that about that?
No, I think my elder one is very shy. My younger one also was doing it. But now they both have sobered down. They're not into social media, much of social media. And I'm not a social media person myself. Very far in between, they'll see posts, because I don't have somebody else looking into my social media, whether it's Twitter or Insta. I do it myself. So I take my own sweet time once in 3 days or 4 days. So I'm not at all, a fanatic, a social media fanatic. And I don't live with how many likings I have or how many views I've had. I'm very content with what I do. Once in a blue moon, I'm on social media. So I'm happy with that.
And how you take the awards, ma'am?
Awards, it's extremely important for any artist or technician, because I think what artists wait for is an appreciation from the audience. So I think it's extremely important. But it should not be biased.
You remember when you got your award and when your daughter got the award and she shared that moment? You remember that moment?
No, for my daughters, I mean, as a mother, their first medal in school, when they participated in their first sports event, or my daughter when she won the best student in science Olympiad in school. So all those are my trophies. So okay. I don't have a single trophy at home, but these are my trophies, and that I have collected all their medals and all their certificates. When they participated in Olympiads and all the certificates they have received. So all that is placed in my, they're framed and placed in my walls. So I think those are my trophies more than what I have collected.
And what are your future projects, ma'am? We are waiting. And the compliment you want to give, the recent movies you loved watching with your family.
I think I've loved watching a couple of films. Like, I loved watching Aavesham.
Okay.
And I thought Fahad was, like, outstanding. I was on the floor laughing. That man is unabashedly such a brilliant actor. So, like, I wasn't completely in love with Fahad and that film. then I'm a huge Vijay Sethupathi fan, so I loved him. And very recently the movie released Maharaja in Tamil. He was outstanding. And then Suri, what he did in Garudan, I think, and I had to call them up and tell them that you guys were like brilliant. So I think, you know, when I saw Maharaja, I texted Vijay Sethupathi saying, you are truly a Maharaja, I text him. So I think I love those kind of films, and I love when you see such good work being put in films. So I like, and I don't hold anything. I mean, I call them up and say that you were brilliant.
But ma'am, people always have a fan moment when they see you. Do you have in your life any fan moment? I mean, would like to share it.
My fan moment? I don't know. I think my fan moment is always when I see Arvind Swamy. My fan moment is every time I meet Mr. Kamal Haasan. My fan moment is every time I see Tarak. That's when I'm like, oh, that's Tarak. That's how I go. Because I am a big Tarak fan. Everyone knows about it. So I have my fan moments, yes. But otherwise, I'm okay.
And what makes you busy nowadays, and especially when you are into the things where, you know, women welfare and so many, you know, social welfare, you are being involved. So what's going on? We want more of the details on that.
I do my work very silently. Like I said, I'm not a social media person. I don't have somebody looking after my social media, or when I travel somewhere, somebody taking my pictures. No, even my daughters refuse to do that. So I live a very, very normal life. So I truly believe that what I do, I don't have to prove it to anybody to show that what work I'm doing. I know I'm doing a good work. So I just remain silent about it. So people ask me, oh, what are you doing politically? You're not doing anything. So I'm like, okay, listen, I don't have to show that what I'm doing. I'm not somebody who will be out on the streets until unless I'm asked to do a certain job. So I do my job very quietly. My party is aware what kind of work I do. And my daughters keep me extremely busy. My younger one is moving to, my elder one just came back from London last year. So my elder one, my younger one is going to London this year. So I'm busy as a mother, traveling up and down London, hunting for a house and getting her things organized because she has to move there for 2 years. So right now I'm a very, very busy mother.
And what makes you fit, ma'am? And I love this. Your tattoo. I don't know. My attraction is going there only. If I tell my cameraman to focus, what is all? It's something's written.
Names, Avantika and Anandita.
Oh my God. So did you have a pain while having tattoo? Do you believe in having tattoos?
No, I love tattoos, but then I stopped because I thought it was getting a little overboard. So I have this, and then I have my best friend's initials here. So they are my, all these five initials are my best friend's initials, so it's there.
So you believe in tattooing?
My daughter is more into tattooing.
That's it.
Yeah.
And what future you would like to say, a message to all the youngsters who love you, and what, I mean, a message to all of them, and one message to yourself.
Message to myself, stay happy, stay healthy. Whatever you do, make sure that you're clear of your conscience, because what I personally believe in is I need to have a good sleep. When I go to bed at night, I have to be very, very much at peace with myself. So I think my conscience should be absolutely clear. Only then I can sleep.
So that's a message for you and a message for all the fans out there.
Be honest to yourself.
Wow, thank you so much, ma'am. So it was a wonderful conversation with Khushbu, ma'am. And for more updates, keep watching iDream. Till then, goodbye.